I love Cisco because Cisco literally changed my life. I got a CCNA that opened up a lot of doors for me. And I moved from South Africa to the UK because of my CCIE. That's what opened the doors.
A big reason as to why Cisco certifications are so life-changing is because they're career certifications. Yep. They're accredited in the industry. And so I'm really pleased, and there's a ton of excitement around the three new certifications that we have just recently come out with.
AI, does Cisco do stuff with AI?
Cisco has done things with AI for a very long time. It's built into the muscle and the fabric of many of our products. We have generally available tutorials and really some good teaching around what are the fundamentals of AI.
Hey everyone, it's David Bomble coming to you from Cisco Live, back again with Pa. Pa, great to have you.
Oh, lovely to be here. Thank you for having me.
So Pa, for people who might not have seen our previous video or might not know who you are, could you just introduce yourself and then tell us about some of the updates that are happening?
Yeah, absolutely. My name is Pa Marat, and I'm the Vice President of Cisco Learning and Certifications. And our charter, as you may know, because you've been with us a while, is to make sure that our community or anyone interested in getting a career in networking or cybersecurity or security has the skills they need to be proficient in their careers and, of course, in their jobs.
A lot of people watching call me a boomer in jest because I'm not really a boomer, but I've been doing this for such a long time. So I know about all the certifications over the years. And just for everyone who doesn't know this, I love Cisco because Cisco literally changed my life. I got a CCNA that opened up a lot of doors for me. And I moved from South Africa to the UK because of my CCIE. That's what opened the doors. So, you know, I really believe in this. But perhaps you can tell people, you know, not just my personal experience, but the feedback that you get from the community about why Cisco certs are so valuable.
So first of all, we get so much feedback and the stories that people tell about the life changes that happened as a result of getting a Cisco certification, just as a result of getting a CCNA. And then, of course, the higher certification, the more doors start to open. Yeah. And so I never tire of hearing those stories. It's absolutely music to my ears. I think a big reason as to why Cisco certifications are so life-changing is because they're career certifications. Yeah. They're accredited in the industry. Let me tell you what that means.
Yeah.
That means that we have an accreditation from an outside agency so that they have that notoriety and that accreditation that says these are skills that this individual has as a proficiency, as opposed to a product or a vendor.
Yeah.
These are industry certifications. So not only are we bound to make sure that they are defining skills or testing for skill proficiency, but we also take a lot of purpose in making sure that they are aligned to the jobs that are in demand today. And that's what makes the difference.
Yeah, I mean, I always recommend if someone wants to study cybersecurity, I'd say you need to have a foundation in networking, and CCNA will give you that, but it also opens perhaps other doors for you if you want to look for a job. Because at the end of the day, people do certs not to get a cert necessarily, they get it to open doors to get a job.
Absolutely. I mean, it demonstrates proficiency. It's like having a degree.
Yeah, it's amazing. For me, the CCNA is the classic example. It's been around for years, gets updated, but it's still as relevant today, if not more relevant today than it was in the past.
Well, that's part of our accreditation. We're constantly updating all of our certifications with new technology, with new skills. Again, the key here is for the skills that are in demand in the market.
So that leads me to the next point. You've released some new certs. I was interviewing Karim earlier. I've linked the interview below. He was telling us about this new certs, but can you tell us like from a broad level?
Sure, absolutely. Let me link back to the industry certification. I talked about how we update certs, but before we create a new certification, we again go through extensive analysis, looking at labor stats, looking at skills in the market, looking for jobs in demand before we create a new certification. And so I'm really pleased, and there's a ton of excitement around the three new certifications that we have just recently come out with. Cloud connectivity.
Okay.
Secure cloud access, and assurance for networking. Let me break those down for
you
if you don't mind. So on the cloud connectivity, this is all about SD-WAN, firewalls with security services, multi-factor authentication or user authentication, as well as looking at those cloud platform tools in terms of how do you connect from an enterprise to a cloud. Our second one is secure cloud access. And that is looking at the security policies. This really gets more into cyber,
yeah,
because it's looking at security threats. It's looking at security operations. And then, of course, it's looking at all of that end user and device security, taking into consideration workload security, data security, and application security. And then our last one is assurance. Because you've connected to the cloud, you've now secured the cloud, now you need to observe the cloud. Yeah. And this is also where our predictive AI comes in that Cisco uses. Because you're now able to use data analysis, taking a look at what's going on from a performance as well as a security threat, do troubleshooting, and then, of course, do diagnosis and resolution. So hot, 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 in demand, industry certifications. These are what is going on in the world today.
So are those different to, say, like an AWS cert or something else? Is there like a specific Cisco angle to them, or how are they like different?
So they're different because they're connecting to the cloud.
Yeah.
Right. So in this multi-cloud or hybrid world, you're constantly going to be connecting into a cloud and back to an enterprise. So we're really covering that connectivity, the security, which really touches on the cyber that you referred to,
yeah,
where you need to have that capability and those skills, and then the assurance inside of it, really the observability of the network using predictive AI.
So I want to come back to that, but I want to latch on what you just said now. AI is like everywhere. Since ChatGPT got released, it kind of like got into the mainstream, if you like. Does Cisco do stuff with AI?
Cisco has done things with AI for a very long time. It's built into the muscle and the fabric of many of our products, Meraki Insights, ThousandEye Insights, Catalyst Assurance. So Cisco has been using predictive AI.
Yeah.
The difference is, of course, generative AI.
Yeah.
And we know that these are skills that are evolving. In fact, in Cisco U, which I'm hoping everyone has registered for, we have generally available tutorials and really some good teaching around what are the fundamentals of AI? What is this, you know, from its basic level? And then, of course, the tutorials so that you can get your hands on it. You can start to play with it so that it evolves and it becomes a kind of like a productivity tool,
yeah,
to be able to use.
So that's great. So Cisco U, just for everyone who hasn't watched our previous videos, I've linked them below. I interviewed Kareem. I also interviewed Pa. Cisco U is fantastic because there's like a free tier, right? And then there's other tiers that you can pay for to get access to more content.
Yes, there's a general availability tier. And we put a number of tutorials in there that people can go in and start getting hands-on with right away. We have podcasts in there. We have webinars in there. In fact, we'll have all of our session content from Cisco Live, from Cisco U Theater, inside of that generally available tier.
Tell me what you can. AI, maybe get a cert from Cisco sometime in AI, or is...
Well, as I said, all of our certifications are built around and on skills that are in demand in the market.
Yeah.
So as we start to see those skills become more hardened, I'm sure we will.
That's great. I mean, I think that's really important to say. I've been doing this for a long time. I've seen that as things change over the years, you introduce new certifications and new skills. The other hot topic is cybersecurity. Cisco do have cybersecurity certs, and perhaps there'll be new ones.
So we have cyber ops,
yep,
and cyber, both at the associate level and the professional level. And that, again, we're constantly evolving those certifications to make sure that they're keeping up with what's in the market. And again, as you mentioned, in our secure cloud access, we've threaded in security and cybersecurity in there, looking at security threats, looking at security operations. There's really a big focus, almost a shift left when you're thinking about networking. You put yourself, you know, really well that you, in order to understand cybersecurity, you have to understand the surface attack and the impact on the network.
Paul, any closing thoughts?
Absolutely. For anyone who's looking to get started in networking or AI or cybersecurity, I really encourage you to go to u.cisco.com and register for our free and generally available tier.
So for everyone who's watching, please go and sign up, show the love, lots of free content, lots of stuff that you can learn there. I always say this, and it's very true, and I'm not lying, you know, this is deep from inside of me. Cisco changed my life.